Welcome to Dauntless, guys. Today we are going to be teaching you how to make the tank build. That's right, guys, a tank build. So about this tank build is it will take any type of hit from any creature in a game, and you'll still do some damage. Now about this build is it will do about 600 to 700 damage, but for the maximum hit, 2,300. That's pretty good for a sword user, to be honest. And I have like a 10-minute clip at the end that will show you how well this armor comprehends and how well it does in danger. Now this So this build is mostly about survival and it self-reses. That's right, guys. It self-reses you. There's none of that Tragic Echo or Skullforge. Those two are really good. But the difference between this and Tragic Echo is this will actually pick you up fully, give you 10 seconds of immunity, and you'll have enough time to equip a potion to fully heal. I'll show you guys what I mean. But first, let's get into the build showcase real quick. Alright, so what this build is, you're going to need the Contazier. Now, you can use the Contazier or the axe in the shop. Let's go to the shop real quick. Which is a Torg sword or the Torg axe, which will do massive DPS. If you're into tank and damage, then this build would be good for you. Massively. So you're gonna need the Incinerator Song, which is really, really good if you want to be an axe user, if you're an axe user. But I'm a sword user, so this build is exactly for both. Alright, so for the sword, the Contazier, this is what's so good about it, about these two weapons that I just introduced. You could put any transmog you want on these little weapons. Now, what you need for this is the Contazier, the Prismatic Grace, the Nasher Cloak, and the Might of the Stone, and the Fiery Greaves. Now, what you need for perks, you say? Well, this is where it gets interesting. On the sword, you're going to have to put Iceborne 3 Prismatic Cell and Tough Cell Prismatic. And you're also going to need Ardent Cyclone. Now, this is where it's very important. Ardent Cyclone and Adhesive Hilt. And you're also going to need a bond called Inferno Razor. Now, what Inferno Razor do, you say? Now, Inferno Razor will set things on fire, which will actually do extra damage for 230 and set them on fire and does 163 damage for fire hit, which is really good. I like it. It's pretty impressive. Now, what Hilt is, it becomes unstaggerable, meaning when you get hit while you're doing this invasive, you can equip this Koshai Bloom, and you will be guaranteed healing as fast as possible, and you'll be immediately at full health, and you'll be fine. Like, immediately fine. Alright, next is the Prismatic Grace. You're going to need Barbed Cell Technique, which adds a flat amount of wound on damage hit, which is really good. You're going to need a little bit more damage. Now, Nasher, you're going to need Iceborne. Now, this will also add tough, so you don't need more tough. You only need one tough cell. So this will give Iceborne again, and the Mighty of the Stone, which is 3 Fortress, Bloodless Defensive Cell, which protects against wound and cripple wound status. Now, this is really, really important during this build. Now, this actually stops you from actually getting really, really hurt during battle. Meaning, if you have like a plus 6, well, I don't have a plus 6, I have a plus 5, which is pretty bad for me, but good still. So this will stop you from taking massive hurting damage. This will actually absorb all of that, and that way you don't have to take as much damage during battle. Now, the Fury Graves. Now, this one, you're going to need Bloodless Cell Defensive Part 2 again. Which you're going to need to. Like I said, you're gonna need it. It's very important for this build. Now, for this. Now, this is where it comes at play. Now, you know how I said that you spin around and gain health and really fast, like? You're going to need Othric Autumn Cell, which percent increase to Lantern Charge gained from attacks, which is really good. I like it. It's very useful. Now, any other cell will make it, well, go slow. Like, this will go fast, but it won't last long for the healing thing, which ain't good. But that's all I gotta say. So basically, this build is a tank slash damage build for sword and axe at the same time. Now, like I said, I have a 10-minute video of me actually fighting both of these, taking hits on regular and danger. And you'll see the actual prospect of this, how good this build is. Now, you're probably going to be like, hey, Prismatic Grace is bad. Hey, Tragic Echo, I agree, it is bad. I get it. But I'll show you what Tragic Echo really does. You need to learn how to use this build correctly, or else you're just going to die and take a lot of hits. Now, this is a really, really unique build I made myself. I found this out by accident. And I've been doing this in trials. Well, trials, it lasts long, but not as long as other people because they know how to dodge and I don't. So this is good for non-dodgeable players, but it's still good to have. Alright, so we're going to go and pick a creature real quick. Alright, guys. Time to find the beaver to die. Now we're going to let him purposely kill us so I can show you how this build works. So now, I picked a level 9 Nasher for this because I feel like level 1 would have just killed me slow. And like I tried recording that, but it killed me way too slow for that. So I was like, eh, you know what? Let's give you guys an actual, like, ring around of what this build does and how it works. And, like, just, like, little look into it. Alright, now, where is the beaver? Beaver. Where's the beaver? Do I see beaver? No beaver. But, yeah, I'm just gonna show you guys how this build works and what it can do to benefit you whenever it comes into, like, trials and picking up friends. So, I'll show you what it can do. You might be kind of surprised how good this build is, to be honest. But, if I can find the beaver, like, the beaver senses me. Beaver! Look at him! We're gonna die by him soon. Alright, let's get ourselves killed. Alright, beaver. Kill me. Let's see how long it takes for you to kill me. Okay. Alright. That's good. Uh-huh. Okay. Oof. That's good. Come on. Keep on hitting. Come on, you can do it. Look at that. You can kill me. Alright, so once he hits me with a final blow, I'll be at zero. Now what this does is gives me invincibility for 10 seconds, and I can just do this without getting touched. And the best part is, I can just use this and keep hurting him by just healing up even higher. Now the thing with the certain Iceborne. Now, Iceborne, when you get hit and at half health, you will be able to heal right back up to full half health, which is really good. And you'll also get a 40 plus shield with this little tiny build. Now, the thing with this, now this is where it's going to be funny. I love using this because it's kind of cute. So I use Cyclone and Siphon at the same time. And look how much health I'm getting. I get so much health. It's ridiculous. And you'll see at full content in Excavation 10 for 50. And it's going to be insane. You guys just have to watch the full-on video just to see how insane this build is. Like, it's really insane. Like, this build can actually lead you in places and survive in places that you're not even meant to survive in. Now, the thing with nukes. Nukes can still do the same thing. Don't think that the tank build will take it, because a nuke is a nuke, and a nuke can just put everyone at 1 DPS either way. So either way, it wouldn't matter. But this build will keep you alive through danger, and also it will also keep you even more longer alive when you're not at danger. Oh yeah, give me all that health. And like, you will be surprised of how well you will live in this build. All right, now enjoy the guy's 10-minute video of me fighting two creatures, probably 10 minutes, I don't know. I don't remember how long I recorded this. But let's see. Well, you guys will see how good this build is in its full content in 10 for 50 escalation. And it also will probably do well in Trials. It's not Trials Guild, so don't expect it to be good in Trials Guild. Unless you want to try it out, then go ahead. It will still do the same thing, but just a little more damage. But that's besides the point. Enjoy the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Bye-bye.